Proteins are essential for life and are involved in nearly all the processes in our bodies. But how are they made? Proteins are complex molecules made up of smaller subunits called amino acids. The information for building them is stored within our genome in stretches of DNA called genes. The first stage of protein synthesis, called transcription, begins in the nucleus of the cell, where an enzyme called RNA polymerase attaches to the start of the gene. Within each gene, triplets of DNA bases called codons provide the code for each amino acid. The order of the codons determines the order of amino acids, which determines the structure and function of the protein. During transcription, the DNA unwinds and the polymerase moves along the gene, reading each base at a time to produce a strand of messenger RNA complementary to the DNA sequence. RNA is a nucleic acid like DNA and can be used to code genetic information. However, unlike DNA, it is typically single-stranded, contains the sugar ribose instead of deoxyribose, and has a U base instead of a T. The messenger RNA is a transcript of the entire gene and includes the exons, which code for amino acids, and introns, which have other functions such as regulating gene expression. For this reason, introns are then removed from the messenger RNA in a process called splicing. As the introns are removed, the gaps are joined back together to form a mature strand of messenger RNA containing only the coding regions. The next stage of protein synthesis is called translation and occurs in the cytoplasm of the cell. The messenger RNA moves out of the nucleus and binds to the ribosome, the molecular machinery where proteins are made. Once bound to the ribosome, the strand of mRNA is translated one codon at a time, beginning with a start or initiation codon. Another type of RNA, called transfer RNA, brings the amino acids that correspond to each codon to the ribosome. As the amino acids are brought to the ribosome, they join to form a polypeptide chain. Eventually, the ribosome will reach a codon that has no corresponding amino acid. This is known as the stop or termination codon and marks the end of translation. Finally, the polypeptide chain is folded and modified to give its final structure and become a protein.